Welcome to the MSU College of Music. Even though we're still under construction, we wanted to take you on a 360-degree virtual tour of the new Billman Music Pavilion. I'm Michael Kroth, Associate Dean of Undergraduate Studies.
And I'm Todd Wilson, Project Manager from Infrastructure Planning and Facilities.
You can pause this video at any time and use the arrows to look around. Let's take a walk into the Dick and Ruth Charles Atrium on the Cook main floor. The Billman Music Pavilion is a new state-of-the-art facility. With this facility, we have met our goals to expand the music building and create an environment providing acoustically superior spaces for rehearsing, performing, practicing, and teaching music. We have created spaces that will provide the infrastructure and equipment to support 21st century music while increasing natural light, ventilation, and quality building materials that will contribute to the health and well-being of students, faculty, and staff. Musicians subtly adjust their performances in response to what they hear, so the Billman Music Pavilion's rooms are intricately designed for both vibration and sound isolation to allow the musicians to hear themselves clearly, accurately, and comfortably.
So we've just arrived on our tour at the Cook main floor, which runs north and south through the building. And we're going to take a walk first into Shallon Hall.
Shallon Percussion Rehearsal Hall is the new home of the percussion area. This space will primarily be used for group work, teaching, recording, and rehearsals. As an internationally recognized program, the percussion area's facilities will go from inferior to one of the nation's best.
Now, if you look around the space by dragging your cursor as we walk through the inside, you'll see a large window that faces north. This, along with the skylight above, are going to provide ample natural light, as well as a great view into the Roy J. Simon courtyard.
All five of our new or renovated rehearsal halls have high ceilings and specialized wall treatments for sound quality. Shallon Hall also includes large storage spaces for instruments that greatly reduce the time needed for setup or changeover from one rehearsal to the next.
Now, if you look straight up, you'll see a skylight. All of these spaces have skylights, but the finishes in this room are slightly different than the rest in that the walls are finished with a perforated metal panel that's infilled with sound-absorbing material. And on the sloped portions of the roof above, there are vertical baffles that hang down from the ceiling, interplayed with the light fixtures. In all these spaces, finishes have been selected to control absorption and reverberation specific to their primary use. And this method maximizes the performance of the room acoustically and protects the hearing of the musicians within.
The new L-shaped addition and transitions in and out of the existing building will provide a number of new shared spaces. Four new rehearsal halls, a courtyard for socializing, two-story atrium, welcome and social space, an outdoor terrace facing the Beale Botanical Garden, over 40 new practice rooms, an ambisonics workspace, a quiet room for music cognition, instrument storage, and even new bathrooms. We are now heading into large rehearsal, the biggest room by area and height. It is roughly twice the size of our previous largest rehearsal space. It is designed for the primary use of large ensembles, including wind symphony, symphony orchestra, concert orchestra, campus band, and applied studio classes.
Now, in here, the walls are over 34 feet high and almost 50 feet to the roof where the skylight is. And the space is finished with battered or sloped panels from floor to the midpoint on the wall, and that's to cause an angular reflection. That's true for most, if not all, of these rooms. And then the panels that you see up higher on the wall are shaped panels that are intended to break the sound up and distribute it evenly throughout the space so that we utilize the entire volume of the room. Sticking out from two of the walls are enclosures that come out from the face of the wall adjacent to the shaped panels. Those are curtain pockets to hide the variable acoustic curtains until they are deployed horizontally across the wall to tune the room down and make it a little less live if necessary. So we're going to head out into the hallway yet again and go further to the north. As we move, take a peek out into the Roy J. Simon courtyard. It's a circular space where we attach to the existing building. Now there'll be some plantings in there and some loose furniture, areas for students to gather and study. And we make a turn here and we'll move into Eichler Hall.
Eichler Hall is another large space suitable for ensembles including symphony band, concert band, men and women's glee, and applied studio classes. Eichler Hall is also designed to accommodate the future installation of an ambisonics speaker system with infrastructure at the walls, floor, and ceiling reflectors. As in the other halls, there's a storage space and a dedicated AV closet, again allowing for faster transition from one class to the next and therefore more rehearsal time. All rehearsal spaces have tech carts allowing for capture of audio and video using in-house microphones and HD cameras, as well as video projectors for showing scores on the large screen behind the conductor. Connectivity to the spaces will also allow for streaming of rehearsals and master classes with remotely visiting artists and scholars.
So as we head back out into the hallway now, we will make a turn and go down to take a walk through the practice spaces that we built downstairs. When we exit the stairwell, we will be in an area adjacent to where the Billman Music Pavilion joins the existing building. Now we've added 40 new practice rooms on the Bloomquist Forger Moriarty practice floor, which were created for specific music types, making practicing at MSU a safe, secure, and high-quality experience.
Acoustically, these rooms are designed with appropriate levels of sound isolation to allow students to practice without disruption from adjacent rooms. The hard work of your neighbors practicing forte passages will not interrupt your long tones.
Now, all of the rooms that house instruments have card readers for access and protection of the instruments inside. All are built with floating floors that separate them acoustically from the structure below. Of unique design, as we step inside one of the percussion practice rooms, or the percussion and jazz combo practice rooms. All of these spaces have concrete floors that are set on springs, and the walls and ceilings are built off of those floors so that the entire interior of the space acts as a freestanding box that is vibrationally isolated from the rest of the structure.
As we zoom past some of the larger practice rooms, it's worth noting that this entire facility was designed for maximum maneuverability to allow many different activities to go on at once. Now we arrive at the heart of this area, the Brew Student Lounge. The Brew Student Lounge is a space for students, designed with the help of our students, so they can socialize in an area with soft seating, acoustic ceiling baffles, and some new artwork.
So again, feel free to look around as we make the turn here into the stairwell, and we'll take a trip up towards Murray Hall. As we get near the top of the stairs, you'll see off to the right, if you're looking in the direction of travel, that there's a new entrance to the building that comes off of Adams Field. That's one of three new entrances into the Billman Music Pavilion. And we'll head into Murray Hall.
Murray Hall was designed for the principal use of jazz, and it is also a space for solo voice and instrument recitals, as well as chamber groups that may not be suitable for other performance venues due to volume, such as brass quintets. Murray Hall features multi-channel audio recording capability. It includes three cameras for live streaming and capture of rehearsals and performances. In addition to its variable acoustics and attractive wood features, Murray Hall has theatrical lighting and blackout shades for performances.
Now, this space is the most isolated of the rehearsal spaces, and that's to best facilitate the recording of performances that happen within. It also has the only fixed seating in the Billman Music Pavilion with a 24-seat balcony, bringing the total seating capacity of this room to around 145. So as we come out the door from Murray Hall, we exit into the new Charles Atrium, which connects to the renovated Music Building lobby. As we pass through the Charles Atrium, you can see an opening for the commissary kitchen that supports a recital reception space, which will include tables and comfortable seating, which is a much-needed public location for special gatherings.
And we are on the Webb McCullum second floor, which will provide faculty offices, teaching studios, and spaces for students to study. Here's a view from the Webb McCullum second floor of the Roy J. Simon Courtyard. If you look off to the side, you can see the shape of that paved area where there will be seating. There's bollard lighting to allow night use, and it should be a really nice space to gather and relax.
So as we head back south past the elevator, we're going to make a turn into an area overlooking a new door onto Adams Field. And we'll show you the view and a large rehearsal from the second floor. All of these rehearsal spaces have viewing windows, serving as a connection between the public side and the academic side of the house. We'll go back out past the percussion faculty studios to the student study mezzanine. This area, which was funded by gifts from College of Music faculty, staff, and retirees, has 12 stations for students to sit and study, each with access to USB and power for laptops and devices. And as we get to the point of connection to the old building, you'll see where old joins new, as we captured some of the old exterior of the original building, which was dedicated in 1940, including the stone reliefs on the outside of room 206, one of the renovated classrooms in the main building. We'll now walk back past the viewing window into Shallon Percussion Rehearsal Hall and back to the stair landing. And now, thanks to the miracle of modern videography and audio, we'll take you on a quick trip into Hollander Hall.
The former band room, known to alumni and current students as 120, has been renovated into the beautiful Hollander Hall with multi-purpose capabilities and functions in three modes every day. It is a classroom space in the mornings with movable furniture and upgraded classroom technology. In the afternoon, it is the new home for choral ensembles and opera. In the evenings, it functions as a recital space for students and faculty with variable acoustics and theatrical lighting.
The updates to Hollander Hall are very similar to the new large spaces in the Billman Music Pavilion. In this case, instead of being individual clouds overhead, the entire ceiling is curved in cast plaster to do all of that reflection from the top. We elevated the ceiling slightly to give the room more volume, and there's a beautiful white oak surround behind the stage area to facilitate a backdrop for recital use. The room also sets up in a classroom orientation that faces to the west, and then there are some variable acoustic elements and theatrical lighting elements, vertical banners that hang in the south side of the room against the windows, blackout shades for the tall windows so the theatrical lighting can do its work, and two rows of colored theatrical lighting along with one row of white lighting. The stage plot of Fairchild Theater, one of our primary performance spaces on campus, is mapped out on the floor of Hollander Hall, making preparation for productions even easier.
Let's go back and finish our tour on the Murray Family Terrace, another one of our social gathering spaces. It will have garden plantings and places to sit where students and faculty can enjoy the beautiful MSU campus.
This project represents for me one of the high points in my career at Michigan State University. It's been great having you with us, and I greatly appreciate the opportunity to help facilitate the creation of such an amazing new facility for the students, faculty, and staff of my alma mater.
We hope you've enjoyed this tour of the Billman Music Pavilion and renovated space in the music building. We would like to take a moment to publicly thank those who gave so generously to the Billman Music Pavilion. This beautiful facility would not have been possible without their financial support. Construction will be complete in the very near future, and we look forward to seeing you in these spaces soon.